inside. No, what's up in this motherfucker? We got Gudong up in this motherfucker. Got felony up in this motherfucker. Shouts out to my nigga Young Joe. Felony, drop that shit. I know your name. With this, it's Mr. Felony, bitch. I got that 9 on my hip and 2 flips. If you want the trip, but if you want the strap.
Hey, this is Queen Jean. What it do? It's that time for a fabulous West Side Wednesday vibe on the T-Lou Show. Sit back and enjoy the view where they doing it at.
It's the G Lou Show. G Lou. G Lou. It's the G Lou Show. G Lou. G Lou. West Side Wednesdays. West Coast Hip Hop. 7 to 9 p.m. Pacific. Hey. Now just kick off your shoes and relax your feet. You're now rocking to the sounds of the G Lou Lee. In the game like EA, do this shit the G way. Do it for the black brown rules to the keyways. From the west side to east LA, Crenshaw to Huntington, Whittier to East Lake. We play the music OGs low ride to. When it's done to bang, same thing they drive by to. Every Wednesday night, 7 to 9 on the G Lou Show, that's where the west side rides. So kick cat, kick back, fire up the split. Cause we about to take flight on this OG ship. Call 803-4001, but don't forget to put the 914 at the front. Then press the number one to holler at G Lou. I think I got you queued in. Hey, caller, is that you? Caller. Caller, is that you? Westside Wednesdays. LockedOnRadio.com/the G-Lou Show 914-803-4001. West Coast hip hop at its finest, homie. California. G Lou Show. Hey, we just gon' ride, homie. We just gon' ride. Hit that switch though. Original Music Group Productions. Blog Talk Radio in association with the G Lou Show. West Side Wednesday.
Hey, Westside Wednesdays, the G Lou Show. Excuse me for the delay. We had hella difficulties going on tonight. As you all know, or may not know, I'm traveling right now, so I'm on the road. I'm not at my normal studio, so we had some difficulties getting everything set up. That's why we had to start at 10:30. But I thank everybody who joined us and who's here with us now. We got a special guest tonight, the homies from Watts Circle City, Watts Gangsters. From back in the day in the early 90s, doing their thing, and they're going to come on the show and talk about it a bit. Shout out to our sponsors, BTP Media 93 Tweed FM Ism. Like I said, we are starting late tonight, but thank you everybody who joined us and hung around for a minute. Let me go to my co-host, Miss Queen Jean. Queen, what's up? Hold on. Okay, there she is.
How are you?
Hey, I'm hanging in there. We had hella difficulties tonight, so I want to apologize, you know, to everybody. You know what I mean? But you know, I'm not at home, so I'm on the road. So it's like, you know, a few difficulties, but we're here. Just a little late, but
yeah.
Still
we're
here.
That's
going
all
on,
that
Queen?
Matters. Not a whole lot. Just I'm looking forward to hearing the journey of the Watts Gangsters. I'm really looking forward to hearing their story. I listened to some of the music today, and I was like, wow, fire music, real fire. So that's about it.
Right.
Just chilling. How's everything? I'm glad that you made it safely to the destination. You know, that's truly a blessing that you touched down on the safely.
Yeah, that's all good. Everybody's good. I got to see my stepmother. She's doing, you know, doing better. So thank you, everybody, for your prayers once again. But, yeah, we ain't going to make this a sad night. It's Westside Wednesday.
No,
it's
a great night.
Coming up. It's going down in a real way. 914-803-4001 is the calling number. A lot of people probably later don't know if we even went on, so we're going to wait for some people to come in. But our special guest is coming up in a few minutes. Watch Gangsters, West Side Wednesdays, the G-Lou Show, Queen Jean. Let's play some of that music. We'll be right back.
Play it.
The house with the strap tucked, East High Rock, back arms tatted up, talking to the homeboy solo in the pen, heavy in the game with the Mac 10, yeah, I got it sold up, any niggas in the way getting rolled up, better do your thing, never snitch the game or thank ya, gotta keep your G100 with a gangster, and I eat a nigga for breakfast just like a cereal, make a left off a central, dip up Imperial, and I'm taking off like a plane down the runway, and I'm always heated cause every day it be gunplay, watch out for jackets, kidnappers, the city scandalous, a lot of pressure come with the money, but I can handle it, come take a trip to the hood where niggas bleed at, wall the homeboys holler where the weed at, yeah.
Surviving South Central.
South Central,
owning a gun is fundamental.
Yeah, right.
Don't cross state lines in a rental.
A rental,
and I move weight in a limo.
Jackson, right.
Parked around the corner on
Central.
About to move some work to Sacramento. Drop it off to the Soriano. I hope he ain't tripping on my Gouda. I like that ass up like Buddha. And mama told me never take a hostage. So if he don't empty out his pockets, my shooters got the green light like the Warriors on the rock. I always been your number one option, and it don't even matter what we talking. I let the villain mind be the star sparking. And treat a bitch like she always done a pocket.
Every day is going down.
Speak on behalf of our family, of the Almanian family, and in honor of Nip, who was a phenomenal vessel. Nip did it not just for the awards, but for the people. And God allowed him to use this music to speak his truth, give us wisdom, and something that we will forever be able to live with. Yeah.
I'm the grandmother of Nipsey Hussle.
Oh,
wanted to thank all of you for showing all the love that I have felt for him all of his life and will always live in my heart. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Paul, I just want to say something for bro. No disrespect to anybody, but last year, bro was nominated, and it meant the world to bro. And when it was given to somebody else, we looked at each other, the whole team, and we said that was God meant to give to that person. And if it's meant to be, he'll be back here. And God's plan is God's plan, so we went with that. And with everything happening, definitely the whole family wasn't even thinking about this. And when Nip was back nominated, it just reminded me of our conversation. And it's not in anybody's plan, it's in God's plan. So I just wanted to put that in the air and thank everybody. And this means a lot to everybody in the family. Still.
Focus, taking it from a real G, kicking it's the dopest. Focus was my homies that we group on the ancient hustle for survival, running from the police.
So what I do is break, cause every day it's the same thing. Pain on the east, things never change. Trust in the change.
Okay, what's happening, y'all? This is Young Drew with the Tool. Better known right now as Andre Tool. And you are now rocking and listening to the best G-Lou, man. Old school, West Side Wednesday. We ain't gonna do the old school. Man, it's Andre Tool with G-Lou, West Side Wednesday. Y'all know what it is. Come on!
West Side Wednesday, the G-Lou show. Still waiting on our guest, Watts Gangsters, to come in. Anybody out there from Watts, call in. We need to holler at you, man. But we got Watts Gangsters on here tonight. I'm here with the lovely Miss Queen Jean. Queen, I'm gonna need your assistance because I'm going through a lot over here.
Hey.
We got anything going on?
That LA, that song you just played, that video, that LA music video is dope. Have you seen that video? They shouted out all the cities from Watts, Carson, Long Beach, Southgate, Inglewood, Compton, and that's a dope video. I checked that out today. It's like, wow.
Yeah,
have you seen the video yet?
Yeah.
Hello?
Can you hear me? Oh, okay. I don't know if you can hear me. Have you seen that video?
Yeah, I watched it. It's a dope video. Shit was hard.
Yeah, it's pretty dope.
I like it. Okay. Well, they say our guests are here, Watts Gangsters. Hold on. Let me see. Sorry again, people. We got a lot of difficulties going on tonight. I'm not at my studio. Hello.
Yo.
Yo, what up, man?
Yo, what's up?
Yo. Is my mic on?
Yeah, your mic sounds nice. Mic check,
baby.
Yeah, somebody was giving me a compliment. I was just trying to say thank you. I didn't know if y'all could hear me or not. I was getting compliments. I appreciate that.
I didn't know you was on the line yet. I was looking for your number.
Oh, yeah, man. I've been out here from the gate.
Yeah, man, we on.
Okay, who we got
How
up? We got Dito. Who else?
You over Mr. Sunny, what's up?
Okay. What's up with it, man? How y'all doing
what's
tonight?
What's up, G-Lo? Oh, man, we good, man. How you doing, baby?
Doing good, man.
Good
to have you on tonight, man. Like I said, I'm not at my studio.
It's always a pleasure.
Yes, sir. Like I was telling y'all, I'm not at my studio tonight, so I'm, like, out. So we had some difficulties, but we got everything good, man. I'm just glad to have you on here tonight. That's my co-host, Miss Queen Jean, the lovely lady you hear over there.
Okay.
How you doing?
All right, how you doing?
How you doing?
Good, yeah. I was
the
one shouting you out on that LA music video. That's a pretty tight video. That's dope. I like that.
Thank you. No, we appreciate it. It's hard to do something, you know, nowadays, you know, on a low scale, you know, with all the mainstream stuff, man. If people only pay attention to, like, you know, the big stuff, man. It's like, it's almost like boxing. People only know you until you're the main event.
Yeah.
Right. Hey, since we got y'all on here, man, before we get started, just like you were talking about things have changed now and all that. Let them know first who we got up here, man. We got the Watch Gangsters. Then introduce yourself to the people, man, who ain't heard from you in a while.
Go ahead. Go ahead, fella.
Yeah, what's up? This is Mr. Fella, you know what I'm saying? Mr. 1006, half of the Watch Gangsters out here representing. I'm just dipping through Cali, so y'all gotta bear with me. I'm in my car phone, the Bluetooth, so shit, if I go in and out, my bad.
Oh, man, it's all good. It's your boy D-Dope, you know what I'm saying, from the Watch Gangsters, man, straight out of California, man, L.A. bound. You know what to do.
For sure. Hey, man, tell us, man, because, you know, a lot of people heard of the Watch Gangsters, but then they didn't see them no more, you know, since the 90s and all that. And, you know, some people know you, some don't, but you had a big impact of what you were doing at that time, especially coming from the part of Watch You Come From over there. So could you tell us, man, how the Watch Gangsters got started in the first place and why we didn't hear from you afterwards?
What's up, Cap? You want to go?
I'll go ahead, Don.
Well, we are first cousins, man, you know what I'm saying? Our mothers and sisters, you know what I'm saying? And right. It wasn't really no problem starting it up. He was always rapping, you know what I'm saying? He like a couple years older than me, fellin' a couple years older than me, and he was always rapping, so I basically followed the trend. And, you know, he was born and raised in Watts over there, man, and we came out at that time when hip-hop was real live, man, you know what I'm saying? When it it was Pac and Big and everything, the Bone, I'm talking about, you know, it was a real live time at that time, man, and we was getting a lot of love at that point, man, and once Pac got killed, you know, the West Coast kind of like this, it kind of hit the fan, and everything went down south with Master P and all that, and it went to New York with 50, and it didn't kind of bounce back around to California, man, until Game came out, man, and that was years later, man, you know, that was years later, so it wasn't nobody trying to sign nobody from the West Coast from like 95 to about, I say, 2000, what, 15? Am I like 2010 at least, Cap?
Probably a little bit before that, though, for sure. It's
hard for us. Yeah, he's in and out.
I'm sorry, I'm going in and out. Damn.
No,
you hear me?
No, yeah, you good?
No.
Yeah, man, I probably got a bad reception, man. I'm driving, like I said, but yeah, it's hard for a West Coast artist, man, because they got that perception that, you know, we all. You know how they think we are. We all gangsta. I mean, we got gangsta music, but we just do music for the people, basically. You know, we doing a music about lifestyle. It's not really glamorizing anything. It's just how we was living.
Yeah,
right.
And a lot of times the name was scared people off, and not knowing that we ain't just making gangsta music. We just gangsters, but we making all kind of music. But you know, the name a lot of times is almost like a pit bull. Once they hear the name. A lot of times it kind of like steer people in a different direction.
Yeah, it kind of like the automatic turn off from the gate. You know, they don't even want to give it a chance. If you get a music a chance, and I guarantee you something you like on there, I can guarantee you that.
Hey, right.
You said you think having
right,
a name.
The question.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, go ahead.
Can you hear me? Okay.
Yeah,
okay,
Mom, he's going in and out on me. Go ahead, Don. He's going in and out.
Yeah, go ahead, G.
Okay, I was gonna ask, did you guys ever think that name later down the line kind of like you said, scared people off or held you back far as moving forward? Once, especially when things shifted from LA, the rap game, and it was difficult. Do you think that name kind of hurt you as well? Looking back.
Yeah,
on,
man. I mean. When it first started, it was kind of like a real raw, in-your-face type of thing. So it helped us a lot because nobody was kind of coming with that, like, kind of straight-up rawness. But then, like you said, as it swung away from the West Coast, and then our largest gangsters is Watts. So basically, it's almost saying California. And during the whole California boy, it definitely hurt us. It definitely hurt us, you know. But, you know, things happen for a reason, man, and you know what I'm saying? I can't say I would go back and change it, But I definitely thought it over and definitely felt like, you know, like as time went on, it worked against us.
Right. Hey, Dito, you got some feedback back there.
Oh, that. Oh.
Okay. Okay, that's better. Now we're gonna ask.
I'm about to stop.
Okay. Call me over there. Who was y'all signed to back then?
We were signed to Priority / Hill Rap Records.
Priority.
Yeah.
Queen J, you have anything you want to ask, homies?
Yeah, I just wanted to say to both of you all that I lived in Watts. I stayed right down the street from the Watts Towers, and you know, right where that Hercules is Hercules still down there?
Yeah.
I stayed across the street from that elementary school, Ritter. That's where I live.
Uh huh.
Okay.
So,
that's right.
Yeah, so I'm familiar with the Watts area. I went to Markham Junior High and all that, and the Pink Market. Was that the Pink Market that was off of Imperial over there? You had to pass the projects to get to that store. Yeah, right there in the little cut. So yeah, but
that's Ace High.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, in the cut.
Yep, in the cut. So yeah, I enjoyed my stay when I stayed over there. I was young, but it was cool. I enjoyed living over there, especially living down the street from the Watchtower, because we used to walk the tracks all the time to go down there just to visit. And a lot of people don't know the history on the Watchtower. They just, you know, it was a little Italian man that built it, started collecting all that junk, they call junk. It's, you know, now it's not junk. It's, he probably didn't know what it was. Right.
Exactly.
Right. And he probably didn't know what it was going to be like that.
No, he
you guys' album is definitely underrated. Your first album
you
made is definitely underrated, because I listened to your music, all of your music today, and I have to be honest, I didn't know anything about you all at all, but once I started listening to the music, like the brother said, you're going to definitely find something on there you're going to like. Well, I have to let you know I found everything on there that I like. It was not one that I didn't bebop to. And then your song Wannabe, I know there's a story behind that song about a young man. Can you explain that to the, like, share that with the audience?
So Wannabe is basically it's almost like how it stands for today. It's like you'll hear a lot of people, you know, like how we said it was a curse, how like the name Watts Gangsters worked against us. It's almost like it's coming back around and working back in our favor again, because now everybody wants to be a gangster. Everybody wants to be a you know, like a hood dude, you know what I'm saying, trap star and all this kind of like street type of person. And so with the Wannabe thing, it was like about like, you know, all the gangster shit ain't really cracked up what it's all to be. Now, a lot of people, like you might hear us that glorify it and stuff like that, but shit, we all in. There wasn't no decision. So it's a lot of times like when you dealt a certain card, you just making the best of it. You know what I'm saying? So it ain't necessarily that this is the hand that you wanted, but this the hand that you got. So, you know, you're going to make it work for you. So, you know, a lot of time when I you know, we sit back and thought about it and said, you know, a lot of these kids going to hear this stuff, and we want kids to know, you know, it's a lot of people that try and get into this stuff and try to be gangsters, and they weigh in over their head, because that stuff, it ain't for everybody, you know. And you see a lot of bad things happen to a lot of good people, you know, trying to be something basically that they not. That's what that song is about.
Yeah, I read about the young man who was 13 years old. He had gotten involved in a play called The Young Writers Lunatics. Was that song based from him? I mean, I know I understand what you were just saying, but did you guys get the song, make the song because of him wanting to be part of, because he was a wannabe. He wanted to be in that life so bad. He ended up going to prison for 5 years, and I think when he got out, he didn't even live that long.
No. It wasn't about him in particular. It was about basically about a couple. It was you know, it was like countless guys that we knew. It was almost like a trend in the community of, you know, because it was tuna and it was sharks, and you know, you know a sheep can't not going to be able to blend in with with the rams, but he could try, but he's going to always end up bad, and you know, it's always going to be a bad, you know, the outcome will always end up bad, and we just wanted to speak on that, you know, and it seems like that will never ever go away, like that scenario will never fade.
Yeah,
that resonates today with what's going on today.
Yeah, it does.
Yes, it
and
does.
And Watts always
got
a bad name too. You know what I'm saying? They always put a bad vibe to Watts. So I can understand you guys having the name Watts Gangsters, and like G Lou was saying that it hurt you guys in the beginning, but that was the way it was in Watts, because I mean, they always gave Watts a bad vibe because we were surrounded by projects and, you know, those type of things. So, yeah.
Cal, you still there?
Yeah,
he probably cut out all the way. But
he cut out all the way.
It's definitely like it's the forgotten city of California. It's almost like it's our slums of,
right,
let's say, America, so to speak. Like, if something happens there, you won't hear about it. If somebody get their head blew off, I'm talking completely blew off, you will never know about it. You will have to search this. You have to go on the internet. You have to search and find it, because it will not be televised. It will be swept up under. It will just be swept up under the rug really quick, because it's like a, you know, even if you go over there and just go over there and just look, probably from the time you were young, it looks exactly the same. These small, tiny little churches, these neglected stores, this trash all over the main streets. The street sweepers aren't even, you know, maintenance in the area. And it's, you know, the houses are super close together. It's overcrowded.
Right.
But you know what? It's a lot of love in the city, too, because people are forced to live shoulder to shoulder. But at the same time, like I said, it's the forgotten. It's the city no one wants to talk about.
Yeah, because the houses were right close together. We had this like huge backyard, and right behind our backyard was another street. So yeah, we just, you know, like I said, I stayed on Santa Ana. So we did. Everybody knew everybody, you know, and I was living there back in the days, in the early 70s is when I lived there. So yeah, it's exactly like you said. It was trashy. It just looked like the slums, and that's how we were treated, you know. But we knew who we were as people. You know, they probably thought we were slums outside of that area, but we knew who we were as people. It was we were very unified as people, you know, because we all come from the same. We all lived there, so nobody turned their nose up at nobody. We didn't have time to do that with each other because we were neighbors. So you living here, you're next door to me. Hey, we're in the same poverty right here together. So let's not, you know, act like we're better than each other. And we didn't act like that with each other then. So yeah, I hear you, and I agree with you on that.
Once the '80s came and the gangbanging hit really hard, everything really got real rough and real tough. And in Compton was probably the last city that the white people left. So they didn't really turn up as fast as it did in Watts, far as, because, you know, Watts, like you said, everything was real crammed in real close, and everybody knows each other. So it's basically the people fighting each other from the people who you went to elementary school with. So you guys all know each other. We all know each other. Mm-hmm. There's some on different sides of the tracks, and then the gangs segregated everybody, and it just, you know, it just was it's almost like a madness, you know, wrapped in with it's almost psychotic, because it's a lot of love, but it was a lot of madness all rolled up in one, you know. And if you didn't know what was happening, you probably couldn't even see it. But a lot of violence, you know, went on there. And I lost a lot of friends. I lost a lot of dudes, you know, a lot of people that I know. I'm like a Vietnam vet. Now, I know probably over 50, 60 people lost their lives. Who I used to just chill with and look into their eyes and hold a regular conversation with.
You know, I almost lost my life on several occasions over there, you know, but it all comes with the territory. And, you know, I'm just happy to be right here talking to you guys right now.
Hey, you guys come from the haciendas over there, right?
Yeah, our neighborhood is right behind the haciendas. You know what I'm saying? Okay. The haciendas is Bloods. Our neighborhood is Paru's, but it's the same. You know, it's pretty much the same thing. But no, the hacienda is like a little project, and where we come from is actually houses behind the project.
Okay. Wow. Okay. That's crazy. Circle City, and then again, being from that area, we hear a lot about people coming from the PJs or the Nickersons or the Grapes. But like you said back there, that's kind of in the back as well, where we don't hear about a lot coming up out of that area. So, you know, to hear from you guys when you guys put it down was a good thing. You know what I mean?
Yeah. You really wasn't hearing nothing from Watts. You was hearing something from Inglewood, you know, Long Beach, Compton, I'm talking about everywhere else, but wasn't nothing coming out of Watts, you know what I'm saying? And that's why I figured that, you know, we put the Watts stamp on there, to let it be known, you know, because wasn't nothing ever coming out of Watts. And even to this day, when somebody might come out with a song or something, that's the last thing you'll find out from is that they from Watts, because they kind of, they're afraid to carry that on their back because they don't want that stigma that might hurt them.
Right. Mm. Did you guys
No, they want people to find
out.
Go ahead.
Go ahead, bro.
No, I said they wanted people, they want to go ahead and maybe blow up before people even find out, oh, he from Watts. Oh, okay, he from Watts. But at this point, it's too late. The doors are already open, and no doors got shut because of that. You know, people don't want to take that chance.
Right. Did you guys ever do any collaborations with any other Watts artists that was out back then, or FTBs, or the who else? You know, whatever.
Yeah. We did do a collaboration with OFTB, but you know, they had a lot of madness in their camp, man. You know, because they were signed to Death Row, so when you go to studio, man, it'd be like 50 dudes up there, man.
Right.
Man, it was crazy up there, man. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it was real unorganized the way they had it, but we definitely did a song with them. And was anybody else? Oh yeah, Cam. You know, we did a collab with Cam too.
Okay.
And
yeah, that's my guy.
And that's on his album too. Yeah, that's on his album. What's the name of that album, man? It's on one song called Representing. I forget the name of that album right off, but it's on his album.
Not the Camnesia. Camnesia.
Is it Camnesia? Nah, I don't think it's Camnesia. What's the other one?
Let me see my guy Ali. I know. Ali, what's up, man? What album was that on, Ali?
Oh man, you know, I don't know, man. I should know though. I should know, but I don't. You know, but I know D Dope. I know D Dope though, man. That's my family, man. You know what I'm saying? He's a true OG. And not only is he an OG, you know, he also did some things with Rodney O and Young Melee. You know, y'all know who Young Melee is. He rapping with, Dub C and all them, man. But, you know, D-Dope,
yes,
D-Dope was a real, real dude, man. Straight gangster, but got a heart bigger than a whole Watts, man. You know what I'm saying? I know that,
man,
because
I appreciate that, man.
Because when I was broke, and I didn't have nothing. I was ripping up in his office back in the days, G. Lou and Queen Jean up in North Hollywood. And D-Dope would come through, make sure a nigga got something to eat, make sure a nigga had something to smoke, you know, and make sure a nigga had a friend. You know what I'm saying? And that's what he was, man. He was a real dude, man.
Right.
So I just want y'all to know that, man. That dude is real, real powerful. And I always got love for him, man. I respect that dude all my life, man. And I'm happy to hear him. When y'all say, yes, sir.
Hey, Ali, tell him about when you went to the county jail and you ran into a cat up in there, man. Say he knew me up in there. Remember him?
Oh yeah. He was from Watts. He knew D-Dub. I was locked up for a minute. I got into it with the LAPD down there at you know, out there in the streets, man. They thought I was gonna be a sucker. I started swinging, G-Lo and them. They took me to jail, man. But anyway, I got locked up, man. I went in there with my homeboy named Tank was up in there, man. And he was looking at me for a minute, and then he got to talking to me, and he didn't think I knew nobody. When the first person I said was D-Dog from Watts, and he was like, oh, man, his eyes got big, man. He left me alone, man. He became my friend up in there, man, kept a lookout for a brother, man. So, you know, D-Dog runs deep, man. And I'm just happy to hear when he was going to be on the show, man. I had to call, man, because I've been looking for you, D-Dog, man. I've been trying to get your number from Greedy Green. You know, Roddy, you don't really talk to a nigga no more. So, you know. But, yeah,
hey,
man.
It's always good to hear from you, baby. But, hey, you know what I want to tell you, too, man? Tank, rest in peace, man. Tank, rest in peace, it's, man.
Man.
Yep, man. They shot him up all over there, man. Which, you know, it's all, you know, that's the life, man. You know what I'm saying? That's why you probably met him. It was meant for you to meet that cat, man, and, you know, for you to meet him and, you know what I'm saying, see the whites in his eyes and the electricity inside that dude. You know what I'm saying? Because, like you said, to every bad side to a person is a good side to him, too, man.
Yes, sir, man. But yeah, man, I'm right here, man, listening, man. But I just want to let y'all know, man, that dude D Dope, man. I call him Tay sometime, you know, and you know, I ain't gonna give y'all his real name, but you know, I call him Tay, and you know, that's my family, man. That's my family, man. He always looked out for Rev Ali, man.
Love,
I mean, we've been, we hung out every day, man, all day, all the time, man. You know. And he trusts me too, cause he know I ain't gonna even go into it, but he know he can put stuff with me, man, and know he can come back and it'll be there. So you know, I just leave it at that.
Oh yeah, y'all. Oh right. Yeah, man. Come on, man, my boy.
I'm glad you got to call in, Ali. Holler at the homie, man. I didn't even know all that, man.
Yes. Yeah.
Oh yeah, man. But Ali know a lot of folks, man. I just ain't no groupie, you know. I know D-Do for a long time, man. I ain't never asked him for no picture or nothing, man. We was just family. We took our own, the Most High took our picture, man, in the spirit.
Right.
Yeah, that's real shit, man. You know what I'm saying? I was in the trenches with that kid, man, for years. I don't know how we was brought together, man, but somehow, you know what I'm saying? I was with that damn Ali, man. Because like he told you, he was living in the studio, so shit. I was in the studio. He was in the studio. Shit, man, bam, that's how it went.
Those some priceless memories, though.
Oh, yeah, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Right. Shout out to the Rev Ali, man.
Ali,
that's my guy,
Ali.
Man. That's a good dude. Yeah, Ali,
yeah.
Ali.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, yeah, y'all be on the lookout, man. I got two features with Cam coming out with this gospel rap, man. So y'all look out, man. Rebby Rev ain't never gave up. We got some heaters coming, man. I'm just waiting to get back in the studio and mix it down.
Yes, sir.
G Luffy too,
Ali. Peace and love.
Oh yeah, I'm right here listening. You know, I'm walking. You know, hey, tell you, I take care of dogs, cats, and rabbits now, man. I get paid for these animals, man. I be out here pet sitting. Doing my thing, man.
Hey,
get out here in San Diego.
Oh, I didn't know you was going to be in San Diego, man. That's where it's at, man. You know what I'm saying? It's my go down there, man. I'll think about
it. Oh, yeah. Hit me up, man. I'm G-Lew, give me your number, and I'll give you. You can hook up, man. Anytime you down here, man, you know it's an open door for you always, man.
Yeah. Get my number from G-Lew and hit me up, baby.
That's a beautiful thing.
All right, Ali. Yeah, it's a beautiful thing. Let me go to the phone line. We got the homie Snow B. Caller, hello.
Hello.
Yo.
Yo, what's going on, man? How y'all doing?
Doing good.
How you doing
Snow? Good. What's up, homie? Snow Brown.
I'm good, G-Lew. I'm good, Queen. Hey, what's up? What's up with you, Wife Gangsta? How y'all doing, homie? I remember y'all from back in the days.
Yeah, what's up, baby? I think my boy cut out, man. He was driving, man. That shit cut out with this D-Dope, man. What's up, homie?
Chilling, homie. You know how it go, man. I think that album you were talking about by Cam was called Made in America.
Made in America.
Made in America, baby. Yeah, see?
That's the one with the traffic.
Trust me, I'm hip. I'm hip, homie. Don't even care.
Yeah,
I used to live on 92nd and Great, man, so I know all about the Watts program.
Oh, okay, yeah. Well, yeah, yes, sir. You live right in town.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was standing right there, man. I was standing right there with the bakers and stuff, my people and stuff from Grape and all that. You know what I'm saying? The other side.
That's right. That's right. I got people from Grape Street, man. See, when you from Watts, that's what we was just saying, man. You're going to have family from there. I got people from Imperial Court, from Grape Street, from Nixon Gardens, and the Heisen. Because Watts so small, man.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? But everybody kind of know everybody, and at the same time, they kind of show each other mutual respect when it's given, you know?
That's real. Once you say Watts, it's kind of like, you know what I'm saying, niggas show each other, you know what I'm saying, all right, we all call it the Watts card.
Yeah, exactly. You know, that's why you say Watts up, and sometimes you give each other three times high, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's right. So I just want to give y'all your
like what Cam said. You know what Cam said, like that W you stole from me, man, that stand for Watts.
Stand for Watts.
Right, yeah. That's a way back. A lot of people don't know about that. You know what I'm saying? I'm from the west side, homie, but a lot of people don't know about that W, where it come from.
Yeah, man. But it's all good.
That's right.
We share that shit.
That's right. You know, it's all love, homie. Don't even trip.
Real.
For sure. I just want to get on here, man, give y'all your props, man. And, you know, I was listening to y'all way back in the days, and I was doing it, and I still bang you every once in a while on my Spotify. So, you know, shit, do what you do, man. Keep doing your thing. Keep your head up. And, you know, much love to Jiglu and Queen. You know how it go.
Hey, I'm enough love, man. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, good, you know, appreciate you calling in, homie. And, you know what I'm saying? We still around, homie. Happy to hear that you still around, too, champ.
Oh, yeah. Appreciate it, homie. Appreciate it. I ain't went too far. I ain't that old. I'm only 48. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
I've been through the trenches and all that stuff, but I made my way out and did better. You dig?
Yes, sir. Hey, man, you know, it's all a number, man. You know what I'm saying? I started real young, man. I'm born in 78. You know what I'm saying? So I'm about to turn 41 this year, you know what I'm saying, at the end of this year, man. But, you know, man, I don't even look at it that way, man. You know what I'm saying? I see it as every day that I live, man, is a blessing, man. Because I know cats, I'm, you know, to didn't make it. And I've seen 13-year-old kids, with, you know what I'm saying, get shot in the head, man. So, you know what I'm saying? Man, I'm just happy to be around. That's why I said I'm just happy to hear that you're still around after all these years. And, you know what I'm saying? We still banging. We still doing our thing, man. You know what I'm saying? Good looking, homie.
That part.
Oh, yeah, for that sure. Part. On your trip, homie. You know, it's all great. You know what I'm saying?
All right, Snow, much love, homeboy. Skip Towing, shout that out, man. Westside Car Club.
Skip Towing, you need your car towed from. You need your car towed from state to state. We got you from driveway to driveway. Skip got you on Westside CC. We banging the bumpers during your trip.
That part.
Skip up, baby.
With that being said, hey Dito, let me go to this classic right quick, and we'll come right back. Westside Wednesdays, what's up?
Another day, another hustle. get mine some way. Continue with you the next day. As I begin to kick up dust with the felony, with a bitch all on my nuts, yelling D dope bitch. Why you telling me if a nigga die tomorrow? Chick, I know you had no sorrow. I know you both some miss punk bitch, but I bet you better borrow. Nevertheless, I guess I suit my dog beat this. Finna get some Hennessy, and my nigga keep that bomb weed. Believe it or not, the spot was hot. On the pop of the worst nigga that steps up, I beat the first motherfucker. Drop it, copy weed, and making a grip, but taking the break. And when I hit the spot, they shake, cause they're more bitch-ass niggas I hate. But I make my move, cause I know we'll be popping with that killing. Hennessy, you calling for my niggas, won't we chillin'?
It's that bomb shit that I be hit. Hennessy, you calling for my niggas. I'm back to vote my feet, hustling, making it, watching niggas they street. Death come unexpected on the streets of the east. It seems like I'm trapped in the dream, but take the heat to my neck and pulling on that endo smoke, provoking brain cells as I get here. But don't choke up off the chick that we be going on that east side, getting high with my niggas in the cut ride.
Looking for my niggas to chill. Basically going in circles, flowing, blowing, no kill. Finna shake the hood, cause niggas ain't up to no good. Would I be jacked by one time, knowing that I probably would. Trapped in hell, from what I've been. Keeping an eye on every police car, cause dubs I sell. Gotta take a chance, cause I can't be broke. A nigga hustle every day up on the corner. It's that me in trouble, but I make my move. Cause don't know what's popping with that killing. And they say you're crying for my niggas, but we chilling.
It's that bomb shit that I be hit. You're crying for my niggas, but we chillin'. It's that bomb shit that I be hit. Innocent, you're crying for the sickness, but we chillin'. It's that bomb shit that I be hit. Innocent, you're crying for the bold, but we chillin'. It's that bomb shit that I be hit. Innocent, you're crying for my niggas, but we chillin'. It's that bomb shit that I be hit. It's that bomb shit that I be hit.
Back live at the West Side Wednesday G Loop Show with my special guest D-Lo Watch Gangsters. What up, homie?
I think I got Selling back on too.
Yo, okay. Sorry about that.
Okay, what's up? Okay.
Well, sounds good. Y'all still bumping that music, I see.
Yes, sir. Still in rotation.
I'm still playing
bro.
That good music, huh? That's what I like. I appreciate that, man.
Yes, sir. Hey, man, tell us what's going on, man, right now, 2020, man, with the Watch Gangsters. We know what y'all did already. You know what I mean? The paint y'all put where it wasn't. So what's going on in 2020? Do we have anything coming up? Do we have any new music? Or can we get some documentaries, some past history? Like, what's going on in 2020, man?
Yeah, we might have to work on a documentary. That sounds good. Yeah, we kind of in the studio doing music, so we probably put out another album this year. I think we're going to Japan in the summer?
Yeah, I believe that we're going to Japan in the summer. But I don't know. Hey, G-Lu, are you familiar with the album that we dropped in, like, late 2017, 2018?
That's the one that LA was on, right?
Yeah.
No.
That's the one that we came back with, like, when we first just... Basically, when we came from out of retirement, basically, you know what I'm saying, I didn't think that you were familiar with it because you was playing this, and the name of the album is called Can't Stop Won't Stop.
Affiliated. You got to pop that, King Lou. You ain't bumping that? Oh, King Lou.
Man, I couldn't get that one, man. See what I'm saying? So I'm glad you put it out there. Let them know where they could go find that at, though, man.
Oh, man, iTunes,
Spotify,
wherever you get your stream at. Yeah, it's on YouTube, wherever you get your streaming from, you can stream it. You know, it's there. We everywhere.
I didn't see it
on
YouTube.
You just gotta look for it.
I gotta look. I gotta get that one, man. I'm gonna try to play some of that before we get out of here, though.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Got the music on there. Type in Wise Gangsters Affiliated. It'll pop up for you.
Okay. I'm gonna get some of that on before we get up out of here. Queen, you got anything you want to add? I'm gonna go to the phone lines also.
Oh, I just wanted to let you all know that I did download everything that I can find of your music, and now I have. Yeah, I got some good workout motivation music now to add to my collection. So,
hey, you ain't up on all that come through and all that.
You know we appreciate it, but like I feel like it's a lot of good music out there, but don't nobody know about it. You know what I'm saying? And because now everybody check on the internet, so now if ain't nobody who you check and playing it or posting it, nobody even knows it exists.
Right. But it's some okay music out here now, but it's not, you know, like G Lou got some good music and your music is good, and then one of our other Twee got some good music. So I'm old school, you know, so I'm like this new, some of this new stuff is not for me. So
yeah.
I was born in the 50s. Huh?
You don't like auto tune?
No, not really, you know. I don't like to knock nobody, really, but, you know, I'm just old school when it comes to music, so.
There ain't nothing wrong with that. We make music for everybody. We just try to make good music, you know. A good song is something that you can't deny, no matter what kind of music it is.
Right, you know, I feel you, I hear you, but, yeah. But I'm digging y'all's music, so we gonna work on y'all's music.
Thank you. We appreciate that. Pump that in heavy rotation. Get that new album. Well, it ain't even new no more. Affiliated, Can't Stop, Won't Stop. What's that, about like a year and a half old or something?
Yeah, it's still fairly new.
Well, you know.
Yeah, I'm looking for that now as we speak.
Yeah, I'm going to play some. I'm going to play that gangster shit up. I'm going to play that. I'm going to play that gangster shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, play that gangster shit. Put that gangster shit on you.
Wait, we can cut?
Yeah, man.
I'm sitting here trying to watch my words and shit. I didn't know we could cuss.
Yeah,
you good, huh?
Also,
speak on it.
Also, that gangster shit is featuring another young artist out of Watts. His name is Young Ace, man. And you can find him on IG. It's called Real Watts Baby. And he pretty dope, man. A little youngster, man.
He's real dope. It
runs
in the
name?
Jeans, you know what I mean? Ha. Young
his
Ace.
Is Young Ace. And on IG, he real Watts Baby.
Yeah, he got some dope music out. Y'all got to cop that Young Ace.
Hey, before I go to that also, I want to ask y'all, what you think about the game now as well, being in 2020, where it came from, the era you came from, and, you know, how music has really changed a lot for the good and bad. But what do you feel about, you know, the music scene, not only all around, but especially in L.A. as well, and Watts, you know what I mean? But as a whole, what do you feel about the way music is perceived these days, how, you know, what you think about it overall? You know, even though it is number one genre, but what do you think about it in 2020?
You want to go, Kev, or what's up? Kev, you still there? Oh, he in and out again, but
tunnel.
Man, you know, I got something to say about that, man. But look, I feel like, man, the game is, you know, is really good, man, because, you know, it's no creativity anymore. You know what I'm saying? It's just basically the same. You know, yeah, 1, 2, 3, there you go. Next time, now you know. I mean, it's just so easy to do a song. And now all these kids, you know, everybody going to want to be a rapper because they hear these songs and you say, man, I can do that. You know what I'm saying? Even the kids can hear, there's no creativity in it. But like I said, it's easy, you know what I'm saying? So it's like even now, like even my homie BG Knockout, you know BG Knockout?
Yeah.
Did the song with EZ and that.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's my homie too.
he was telling me, he was like, man, you got to dummy down, man. You got to dummy the shit down. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, man, that shit is really hard. And he was like, man, you got to dummy it down because, you know, you can't really, like, it's like Nas. Ain't nobody trying to hear no.
They don't want
to
think
hear no real spitting. Nah, they ain't trying to hear no real spitting no more, man. That ain't what it's about, man. People just want to hear a dope beat, you know, a dope hook, you know what I'm saying? Have a drink, call it a day. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, I still respect it, but at the same time, it's like, you see, I'm going to keep doing my music, man, and I want to keep putting stuff out because people don't never know what they have until it's gone. It's almost like Bruce Lee or how Kobe is now, or let's say Nipsey Hussle. You know what I'm saying? Like everybody hollering, Nipsey Hussle, Nipsey this, Nipsey that, Nipsey this, man. If Nipsey was here today, Nipsey would have told you, man, nobody showed him love. If you look up any interview with Nipsey, he's going to tell you, man, I had to do it myself. Man, I did all my own print-ups. Man, I paid for all my own music. Man, I went and got with the producers. Man, I paid them. Man, we sold out our backseat. We sold out our trunk, man. I didn't ask for no help. And nobody showed him any love. And then after, you know, my man passed, rest in peace, then everybody, oh, you know this, and he was that, and he was this, man. My boy wanted to see the love while he was living, man. You know, don't know, you know.
I fuck with Nipsey since day one. I fuck with Nipsey since day one.
Love after the
my
fact.
God.
But, yeah, man, what about, you know, saying, you know, present, you know what I'm saying? So that's why I want to keep putting out music, and, you know, because I know people going to go back on and say, damn, man, we slept on this shit. You know, but it's all good,
right,
you know what I'm saying? Because ain't nobody perfect.
Right. That's right. All agreed, homie. I just wanted your take on that. You know,
you
2020. I said, I just wanted your take on that because, you know, it's 2020, man. The shit has changed a lot, but like you say, it's good and bad with it, you know. And the good is it's still music out there. We got the internet, right? So you can go find it wherever you just look it up. It's like the Watch Gangsters affiliated, all the older projects.
Yeah, that's
projects,
a real good thing, man. A lot of people
are
in control of their own stuff. It's a lot more money to be made, I tell you that. You know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
We're basically
one-hit
wonder, man, can make enough money to live for the rest of his life, man. But basically, back
that's
in the day, one-hit wonders, man, didn't make enough money, man, to even live in an apartment for a year.
Right. Yep. It's the gold rush for these youngsters out here. If they know what they're doing and how to do it. You know what I mean? Because like you said, it's just easy, and it's this time we're living in with this internet and technology, the youngsters just, they can get it because so many youngsters tuned in to technology. Everybody and their mama, all these youngsters got laptops, phones, whatever that taps into the digital platform entity. So they're always streaming, listening, and in tune to what these dudes got going on, who they like or whatever. So it's just like, wow, a dude can get on overnight. He getting money through streams and all this if he knows what he's doing. So it's a good thing for that, but like you said, the flip side of that is no more creativity at all. I was just speaking to my little brother about that today. There's just no creativity. There's one future and 100 offsprings, you know, and then, you know what I mean? So it's just a lot of stuff going on, but either way, it's all good. I just wanted your take on that. Let me go to this song right here off the affiliated album, man. It's just gangster shit featuring the homie you were just speaking about. Take us to this song, D-Dope.
Yeah, man, well, you know, it's this one dude, man, in Japan, man, and he called me, man, and he had money, man, and he said, man, he wanted to bring us back, man, and that's basically why we came back. And, you know, my first thing is to reach out to any artist from Watts. I know this young cat, man, his name is Young Ace. He out of Jordan Downs. And, man, dude is hard, man. You know what I'm saying? The dude is hard. So I told him, what's up, man? Let's get on the song. And, you know, he came through. Met up in Burbank, California. It was a tight-ass studio. And we went in and laid this out, man. It all came together.
There it is.
Hey. Hello?
Hello?
G. Lou. I think G. Lou probably went off the air for a minute. But listen, I had went on Spotify, and I didn't even type you all's name, man. It just came up, Watch Gangster Affiliated. It just came up, and I was like, okay, how does that happen? But I'm glad that it happened, and I was listening to Watch Up. That's, I mean, every one of these songs is really dope. I mean, like, truly they are. You guys are some dope artists, you know, like, I'm really feeling your music. Yeah, really feeling your music. And I wanted to say it. When we moved to Watts, we moved from Compton to Watts. So it's like, you know, we are truly homeboys and homegirls. You know what I'm saying? Really, it's like truly homeboys and homegirls. It's like, this is real dope.
It's all
I like
same,
this.
You know?
Yeah.
It's all the
and,
same, like I was just telling G, I know Knockout, you know what I'm saying? And people might think that I know him from rapping. No, I don't know him from rapping. I know him from the streets. You know what I'm saying? Because Compton and Watts is like, Compton and Watts is like the same thing.
Right. They like right next door, You go across Wilmington, you in Compton. You come across Wilmington, you right there in Watts. And it's like straight up, back and forth.
Just like
straight
that.
Up, back and forth.
Yep.
Yeah, just like that. And it's just like, wow, because Watts is a square. It's truly a square.
Yep.
You know, Watts is truly a square. But, yeah. I just hate that I was sleeping on you guys and that my children, because I have a daughter who was born in 77. So I'm just kind of, you know, like, how come you guys are not familiar with this? Now your mama up on y'all with some music, you know?
You know, like I was just telling you, if we got Future to post work out on one of our songs and he posted, then everybody will know who the Watts Gangsters is. But without that approval, people don't have their own initiative to go out and find what they like for themselves. They need the validation that everybody like it. So they can say, yeah, I like it too, you know? It's the masses that control everything, you know?
Right.
But I
the
respect
masses.
It, you know. Yeah, I respect it. It is what it is, you know. I'm just glad that I know it and I ain't just lost, like, what the hell going on, you know.
And you guys get a lot of love from Japan, too, because I also seen where you guys were doing a concert in Japan, right?
Yeah, man, we did a lot of concerts in Japan. They, you know, they really, it's amazing to see, you know, like a love like that from another country. From a whole nother culture, like to them, we superstars all over.
Yeah,
like, you know, we like the biggest thing ever. You know, they sleep outside our hotel room. You know, it's
overseas.
Crazy, you know,
yeah,
yep, it's crazy. So I direct a lot of music for them because those are the real fans that really, really, really diehard fans.
Right. I know when I was living in Germany, they just love hip hop, you know. And a lot of our artists that come on, they say that when they go overseas, it's a whole different vibe from the fans overseas than it is than the fans in the States. It's a whole different vibe.
God.
I mean, they give you guys the energy that you guys give because they be so hyped up. They be so hyped up.
Yes.
They give you guys energy to stay hyped up when you on the stage. Yeah, it's a total different vibe.
I don't know if you heard this song by this rapper named Yo Gotti, and it's called Everybody. And basically what he's saying is everybody got money, everybody claim they rich, everybody claim they got it going on, everybody claim that, you know, they got all the followers. It's just like he said, it ain't no more regular people left.
And it's not.
So here in L.A. and California and all this stuff and New York and everybody, you know, they feel like, you know, they somebody. And, you know, they don't really want to show no love. You know, they feel like, who are you, you know? And
right.
When you go to a different country, they, you know, none of that applies to them. They see us and they, you know, they don't try to act like they're all that and then, you know, they're really, really captivated and it's really genuine.
Right.
Really
it's very
genuine.
Yes. Hey, you have a song called Stuck in the Game. Is that an Isley Brothers sample on there where the young lady is singing?
Yes. That's actually a Isley Brothers sample. And a young lady that's singing is, her name is Natasha. And
Natasha.
She's from a group called
Yeah, she's from a group called YNZ that was signed with Def Jam, and she did like two songs on Tupac's album Two Thug Life. You still there?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
You back, G?
Yeah, man, we had so many difficulties, man. I'm sorry about that, bro. I'm not at my studio. I didn't catch a flight, so I'm actually on the road somewhere. And I'm actually out of town, outside of my studio, and I'm set up. And having everything that seems like can go wrong is being me, man. But we're still here, so I apologize for that, bro.
Okay, champ.
But let me get into this song and let me get everything situated. We got it right now. We'll be right back.
Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Let's hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Let's hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit 'em, time to hit 'em, yeah, you know it's on. I'm always ready, shout out to my little homie Stone. And you ain't never gotta worry, cause I keep the chrome. I need to get my mind right, let's roll up a zone. What's up, champ? Wearing beige and some gangster braids. And I'ma need another hit before I hit the stage. Yeah, they paying me a nod just to rock the spot. I'm from Hun, phone blind, fresh up out of wide. And all these dirty ass bums out here acting dumb. Light 'em up, I don't give a fuck where you from. Niggas out here robbing steel, cause they like the thrill. Fucking around with me and you gon' get your ass killed. And every time you ever see me, homie, I was mean. Yeah, I was clean, fresh up on the scene. And now I serve you on the spot, homie, like a fiend. I'm a motherfucking gangster, you know what I mean. Yeah. Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Let's hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Let's hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit him with some more of that gangster shit.
Ever since the youngin', I've been regulating. Hopping out the way with the business, I ain't here to play. Nigga, I'ma do this for my killers who ain't here today. And I be low, never let them know where a nigga stay. Catch me up in traffic, I be sliding. Limo tinted down, couldn't see me if you tried. No stash rock, keep my pistol right beside me. So which one of these bitch niggas wanna die? Look, I ain't worried about it, bitch, I'm caked up. Thumbin' through it. All blue hunnids, I got paper cuts. Take what? Nigga, on my granny, you ain't taking none. Fake tough, but when I come around, he don't say none. You already know what it is. Love. Real watch, baby, block crazy in this bitch. Can't lie, nigga, I'm really on my shit. Nah. Can't get enough of this gangsta shit.
Now I'm broke, I guess I gotta bust my Glock more time. Living this here life of mine, ducking and dodging one time. Gotta stay two steps ahead, while I keep my family fed. At the same time, where the bottom line is only clocking bread. And these streets ain't paid with gold, the city of lost souls. I'll chew you up and spit you out, but I guess that's how it goes. So be careful, I'm not that nigga that you wanna pop that shit with. Fuck with it, and get your motherfucking neck split. I want you, these young boys, niggas take no shit. You can gloss all you want, fuck around and lose your grip. On the streets of the east, I hope you come in peace. So you leap out in pieces like Reese's. Just another chapter in my thesis of G shit I kick. That nigga known as Felon, don't fuck with my clip. Woo!
Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Let's hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Let's hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit him with some more of that gangster shit. Hit him. Hit him, gangsta shit. Hit him, gangsta shit.
Niggas, don't think what's gonna slide through the east. Do a dot, east side. Niggas, don't think what's gonna slide through the east.
Do a dot, east side. Cause my rep is deep. Do a dot.
Don't think what's gonna slide through the east.
Do a dot, east side.
Don't think what's gonna slide through the east.
Do a dot, east side. Cause I rest in peace. Do a dot.
kicking back, thinking about the fools in the game. I watch them drop on the block because the rules never change. Your fame never meant that it was easy. You got with a click and made you some meals. The clock could rip a nigga call shot. Watching my back, peeping all game struck with my hand on the trigger, ready to fill a nigga cap back. It's just the way of my survival skills, making sure that you must be dead on the ride.
What we live in the H, do or die. It's just the way life is. Nigga dropping every day, so who can say I've lived to see the sun when it rises in the moment? I better yet, when it sets, watch your back. You can bet niggas don't. Brains is blowed across the way. Sneaky ass motherfuckers be creeping in every day. It's just another fucking hustle to survive. So if you visiting the east, you should know it's do or die.
Do or die. I'll say what's gonna slide through the east.
Do or die.
Do or die. East side. I'll say what's gonna slide through the east.
Do or die. East side. Cause my rep is
hit. Do or die. I'll say what's gonna slide through the east.
Do or die. East side.
Now it's the gangster dope. I take my time and stop on speed. Motherfuckers is wicked. You got the meal ticket, best free. And I make the choice of suicidal thoughts. And relax, better bring your strap or you might get caught. And perhaps fuck around and get your scary ass lit. Too late for praying and screaming, hollering, you ain't done shit. Young dope from the gangster clique, fucking up fools nonstop, nigga, you cannot fuck with.
The blocks ain't quick when the police hit. But never quit, clock a grip, keep an eye on your hip. Don't slip, or be another nigga passed away. Keep your head up on the streets of late, face flat on the concrete. It's sad what the nigga go through to advance and make his cash. Got us jumping on food. To do or die where I come from. Just hope to let you know. East side till I drop, Mr. Fella.
Do or die. Y'all say what's gonna slide through the east side.
Do or die.
Do or die. East side.
Do or die.
Y'all say what's gonna slide through the east side.
Do or die. East side.
Cause my rep is
deep. Do or die.
Y'all say what's gonna slide through the east side.
Do or die. East side.
Now as I step to my crown, now busters bad. When I bet tonight, I kick that hype shit. Watch gangster staff, and I break the niggas up that think they can get. But a G from east side ride that watch niggas that I play with. I'm breaking niggas off with no hope for a G as I proceed. Smoking weed is a must that I back. He beat you surrender to the south of a 4th Street 6-4, do or die, ride a D.O.P.
Do or die, east side till I'm a memory. Though to a post, I find the Nina and his quick delivery. Watch this on the map and how he ripped it up. Last song on the album, now you know it's what's up. On how it is on the east. If you creepin', they sleepin', and best believe they leave your dome leakin'. And ain't no sneakin' up on your homicide. Put police is quick as a square, niggas better slide out the motherfuckin' way. When they rollin' on the block, it's a spot with a cat. Do or die was the thought in your head. Couldn't have pulled the trigger, but you ended up dead. It's a shame, but nevertheless, we all must dance with this. Nigga dropping in they tracks, so you best stay strapped or collapse and be a victim of a watch. It's Mr. Fatlin signing off. Do or die, 10-6 Street.
Do or die. Don't say what's gonna slide through the east side.
Do or die.
Do or die. East side.
Do or die.
Don't say what's gonna slide through the east side.
Do or die. East side.
Cause my rep is deep.
Do or die.
Don't say what's gonna slide through the east side.
Do or die. East side.
Do or die,
do or die,
do or die, east side, cause my rep is
deep. Do or die,
don't say what's gonna slide through the east side.
Do or die,
do or die, east side,
do or die,
don't say what's gonna slide through the east side.
Do or die, east side, cause my rep is
deep. Do or die,
don't say what's gonna slide through the east side.
Do or die, east side.
What's up, what's gangsta?
Do or die, east side, cause my rep.
Do or die,
don't say what's gonna slide through the east side.
Do or die.
The West Side Wednesdays, the G-Loop Show, with our special guest, D-Dope.
Watch Gangsters.
That's a classic right there. I'm just taking them back down memory lane, bro. D-Dope, you dig? What's going on, bro?
That's right. What's up, baby?
Classics, man. Classics, man. So
you said we got the new album coming this year. Do you know when that's coming? Who's going to be a part of it? Like, do we have any plans yet for it? What's going on with that? This new album we can look
forward
to.
Yeah, man, Yeah, man, we got a new one coming out, man. It's gonna be the album that you hear that song L.A. We just dropped that as
right.
a single, man.
Okay, that's your heart.
You know, like
Benzie
I said,
was loving that video
Yeah, man, I appreciate it, man. I hadn't been working it so long, man. So once I started just doing music again, man, I just wanted to just keep dropping. So we just dropped that one. I didn't even want to wait on the album. I just wanted to just put something out. So we dropped that single before the album
right.
even came out. So we had the rest of the album done probably by the mid-summer, by the mid-summer that we come with it, man, because we go to Japan and do like
we go like and do like a little small tours, like do like 5-6 shows in one visit, right? And go get our money, man, and you know what I'm saying? And it'd be real cool, man, and I like to, every time I go, I like to come with some new
really
merchandise, man, some new product.
They really appreciate us over there. They really appreciate us over there, man.
More than we appreciate ourselves, man. It's crazy, man.
Right.
You know,
from the land to Japan, that's what we say over here. Much love to Japan.
Yeah, man. Yes, sir.
Also, give them all your handles and everything where they can get at you at, the music, the merchandise, you know, your website, you know, where all the music is at, right there, too. So they can tap in.
Yeah, man. Like you see my little IG page, man. That thing was supposed to be old as hell, man. I just dropped that thing. My manager made me get that thing. He's like, man, you gotta set a page up. So I got the new page on there, man. On Instagram, man. You know that's just Watts Gangsters. Period. It ain't hard to find at all. Watts Gangsters is fairly new though. It's only about a year old. But it's gonna grow. As far as all our music on, you can go on YouTube, or you just type in Watts Gangsta music, man, it'll pop right up, man. We on Spotify, iTunes, all that, man. Pretty much all the little download sites.
Right. Okay. There it is. Make sure y'all tap in with the homie. Be on the lookout for the new album coming soon. We hope. And the documentary, man. We need. Documentary just about just the history, and you know, I'm sure you got a lot of own footage and everything, and you know what I mean, to give the people a visual of what Watts Gangsters is and what they were and what they are today, you know, just the history, because you know they need to know that, homie. You know, these youngsters
with these YouTubers,
all this right there, they can get that history, bro, without somebody else telling them for you. You know what I mean?
Exactly, man. You know what? You're right, man. And that's a real good idea, man. So I'm going to jump on that, man, because, like you said, today is all visuals. You know, I mean, the audio is cool, but you need the visuals, man, because
they
people want to lock it in,
man. Get that picture. Right.
They
get
do,
the picture
bro.
Painted
do,
and put that visual out. For sure.
Yeah.
So that's what's up, man. Look for that and all the handles. Queen G, you got anything else for the homie? You ask him?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Oh, okay. No,
yeah,
I don't have anything
for a minute.
Else.
You know, the whole we've been having difficulties, but we're here. We
oh, yeah,
you.
I was still
ahead,
carrying
sorry.
On when you were out. I was okay. still having the conversation.
Oh.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. We kept
we were
it moving,
we was...
man. You know, the show must go on.
Oh, y'all kept,
yeah.
Okay, y'all kept it moving for me. Okay. Man, I thought I was all the way out and nobody could hear anything, man. So. I'm glad you guys here some time, bro. I had no idea, man.
Yeah, we were still, teamwork.
That's what my homeboy said. No, said teamwork make the dream work, man. Much love. I didn't know that, bro. I thought I was out.
Yeah, you know, I'm staying down for my crown, G. Lou. You know what time it is.
That's
you know, I'm staying down for the crown.
That's why you wear. That's why you wear the crown. That's why you wear the crown, Queen. <My mom. laughs>
But I just wanted to say to you,
sorry,
you know,
man,
to the brothers, you're welcome. To the brothers, you know, blessings to your prosperity. I'm going to have my eyes open and my ears open, looking for anything that's coming out from you all. So, you know, blessings to your prosperity and peace, love, and blessings to you all. And be safe when you out there, you know, out there in the streets. Just be safe. And I just want to give you my blessings. I enjoyed the show. I enjoyed learning of your journey. So,
We really appreciate it. You know, I'm going to speak on Stellan's behalf, too. You know, we really appreciate it. And it ain't so much of, like I was telling you guys, it ain't so much of the main shows or the big mainstream shows who make artists. It's people like you guys. It's people like you guys that reach out to the artists, and people get to really hear from the artist. It's almost like DMing the artist.
Right.
You know, you really get to hear from the artist, man, because by the time they make it to those big mainstreams, man, they done already put in all the work with people like y'all. So I appreciate it, and I appreciate the love, and you know what I'm saying? You know,
You know, we always careful, you know what I'm saying?
I was going to say, since you said that right there, I forgot to ask you. That's a perfect segue. Can you please give us a drop for the G. Lou show, man? That would be perfect right now. From me and Queen Jean for the G. Lou show.
Man, there ain't no problem, man. Look, it's your boy, man, D-Lo, man, live and direct, man, right here, man, from South Central Los Angeles, man, a.k.a. Eastside Watts, man. And I'm right here with my boy G-Lou, man, on G-Lou Show, man. Much love, homie. Keep it popping, man. Keep it lifting, man. Keep killing them.
My man. D-Lo, Watts Gangsta, man. Follow him right now on Instagram, man. Go to iTunes, Spotify, YouTube. Punch that in. Show them some love. Get them streams up. Get that latest project they got affiliated out and get all the other shit. New album dropping soon. Shout out to the homie. We lost the homie, but send our love to him as well, man. But thank you again. Great episode. Great interview. We'll have this up later, too, if anybody wants to listen back to it, though, man. But we appreciate the love. Much love to you, Bubba. Who you got on the Super Bowl, man?
Hey, much love, G-Lou, man. Much love, my boy. You know what? Man, I'm a real L.A. dude, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm a straight L.A. cat, man. So, the closest thing to it, homie. The closest thing to it.
It was 49.
So I'm going with Frisco. Yes, sir.
Okay. Shout out to my girl, Mama Boo Boo. Shout out to Frisco. 49ers, man.
Man. That's still part of Cali, man. I'm going with it, man.
Yeah. That's right. Shout out to the Niners. Well, much love again, though, homie. We appreciate you, bro. Watch Gangsters. Vito. The G Lou Show. We'll be right back.
Much love, baby.
Yeah.
I am G Lou from the G Lou Show. Showing love to the tweed. Yes, indeed. Just waking up in the morning, gotta thank God. I don't know, but today seems kinda odd. It's Thursday, so we gotta let the birds play. Coming up the Shaw, made a left on 43rd place. Hit the liquor store, get everything we need. Right past Dinker, made a left on King. Old school caddy looking way too clean. On my FM-ism, 93.3. It's 81 degrees, feel the summertime breeze. Even got the good word from the Reverend Ali. The double PC with the double OG. After six crews. Mix 93.3. Break down the weed, put it in the leaf. Roll it up nice, hit it twice, now breathe. This is how you do it when you do it like me. Mix some rhythm and blues with a sprinkle of O&G. Now proceed with the program, rolling in the bro-ham. Old school, right before the dough slam. I chunk the deuce up and hit the last switch. Turn the music up and let the beat bump like this. Shout out to the bricks, yeah, the city that I claim. So when I go out, best believe I'm going out with a bang. OG.
Man, she's so fine. It's just something about her ways, man. I ain't never met nobody like her before.
Is that right?
Something about her ways.
Let's go.
It's something about the way she moves, baby.
Yes, sir.
It's something about her way. It's something about the way she moves, baby.
Yes, sir.
It's something about her way.
Let's go.
Something about the way that she moves, she's so fine. Visions of you and me in my mind. Love's trying to find me, but I don't want to be found. Every time I go to sleep, I dream about your love, child. I am just a G-child, giving you my best now. I don't like to rap about it, this is just a freestyle. Meanwhile, she smiles, looking at my resume. Finally, she realized she dealing with a heavyweight. In and out of every state, moving like a kingpin. She don't ever see the work, all she see the dividends. See the type of love we in, I'm fucking with her mind again. She don't want nobody else, cause she like the love I give. Who I am, who I be, who are you to question me? I am just a love chef, cooking up the recipe. Baby, let me set you free and bring you in my world. Something about the way that she moves, she that girl.
It's something about the way she moves, baby.
That's right.
It's something about her way.
verse too. It's just something about you, the way you walk, the way that you talk, the way you move. You got me in the mood for love and I'm all in. I've been looking for a homie to call my lover friend. Hop inside his Benz, it's room for us to grow. In that S500, we moving with the flow. Put you up on game and school you to the low. It's 100 different ways to lose and go broke. Something about the way that you move, I can't cope. But it's something in my heart, I refuse to let go. Hollered at my homie Big Mo to the Z. Got me pimping and crippin' with G Hank in the beach. Swimming with the sharks, now I'm in too deep. But I can never drown homie in this deep blue sea. Practice what I preach and what I'm preaching is true. It's something about the way that you move, it's G Lou.
Hey, how you doing?
Remember me?
I'd have to lose all the brain cells in my head before I forget something fine.
Does everyone need an audition to get to me?
You ain't gotta go through all that shit.
When I choose you.
Mr. Pretty Tony, I mean, you know the rules of the game. I mean, your bitch just chose me. Now, we can settle this like you got some class. So we can get into some gangsta.
Day tree nigga.
Hardcore, making that
your world would see. Cause to me, there's no world outside the CPT. If I don't kick ya or get with ya, cause I'ma stick ya. Pop the chop too much, that ain't a hit ya. So what you got? Come and show me your stuff. Got a million more rhymes, and I'm calling your bluff. As it happens, you're falling to the zone that's insane. Hey, chill, DJ S, it's a constant thing.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we proceed to give you what you need, I go by the name of Big Homie Bay Bay, G Perico in the building with us.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey. And I told my dog,
all right,
you from the West.
Left.
We can't spell the West
left
without the
left
ES though.
Left.
Hey.
G. Never met a crazy motherfucker like me.
Me.
Hands down, coldest motherfucker from the B.
B.
G. C. You don't hate me, you just really wanna see me.
Ooh.
Want a Lamborghini, blue nigga, ready for the big screen. Hanging out the window, throw a two in a big seat. World spinning fast, but I ain't getting dizzy. Sliding with my nigga, getting high like a hippie.
Talk
I'm trippy, I'm money, I'm hundreds, I'm fifties. I walk the yard on five penitentiaries. I came home to my hood and made history. I drive around in Beamer, Benz, and Bentley.
Hey!
Hold it down when everything start getting hectic. Getting dressed with a gang of guns on the dresser. The hood, the first place ever made me feel special. Bitches wanna fuck on what I think is precious. I ain't gonna lie, it feel good when it's naked. But I keep rubbers, got a pocket of protection. Sam documented real young OG. I've been doing good, why the cops want me? Take a bougie bitch on a ghetto ass ride. See a hundred knife and I'll make a quick stop. Got me getting drunk, hanging out all night. My name's G Perico, welcome to my life.
West Side Wednesdays with my partner D. Lou, Red and Blue, keeping it true. Black Fist in the Air, this is my partner right here. Y'all turn in, tune in to him every Wednesday for whatever he got going on. Special guests, good music, unreleased music, or previously released music. G. Lou, West Side Wednesday. Yes, sir.
Yes, I want you to come closer. G Lou Show, Westside Wednesdays. I am G Lou. That's Queen Jean. I want to give a shout out to my sponsors once again. 93.3 FM Ism every Thursday night, 7 to 9 PM Pacific on Blog Talk Radio. Also Skip Towing and Skip Towing. Follow them on Facebook, Snow Brown, Westside CC on Instagram. If you need your car towed anywhere in the land, cross country, and get at the homie, he has you. He got your front, back, and your side. Also, shout out to OG Media, home of the G Lou Show, and also UTP Media Group, Jeff Kwan, who made it all happen. Also, Friday, we got a special guest presented and sponsored by from Cleveland to Cali. My homie's up in Cleveland, all the way to Cali. Chris House, Mo Thugs family, part of the Bone Thugs family, will be on Friday. You know, I'm going to still be outside on the road, not in my studio, so hopefully we got it on point. I'm going to make sure I'm on point early, but Queen G, we got that coming up. Also, I want to shout out to the lovely ladies out there. Shout out to Miss Dee Dee Harrison, our sponsor. Go follow her on Instagram. Check out a wonderful episode on the G Lou Show podcast, streaming everywhere, Spotify, iTunes, all of that right there. Check out Queen G's interview, all the queens and the ladies. Check out Hanks to the Gangster Classic interview, Queen Jean held. I'm getting great reviews from that, so go back and listen to that. And this weekend, I'm dropping the Big U episode we did a minute ago. So I'm going to drop that this weekend as well. So be on the lookout for that. G Lou Show podcast. And we got Mama Boo coming up soon, Tweed Cadillac. Who else we got? We got more people. Just be on the lookout for the G Lou Show podcast, right, Queen Jean?
Right. Streaming on all platforms. Don't sleep on it.
Don't sleep. Stay warm.
No,
because like
I've listened to all my podcasts. I've enjoyed every last one of them. So, yeah. So that's good that you're getting some good feedback on your on the podcast as well. That's a good thing. Beautiful thing right there. That was a great show, too, Jesus.
Yeah, it was. We made it happen. Thank you, Queen. Always by my side. I couldn't have done it without you, so thank you. You know what I mean? We definitely had some difficulties, but it's all good. Thank you to all the people who tuned in and listened to us, man, showing us love from the land of Japan all the way where I am and where you are. You did.
Yes.
Friday night, we're back at it. Sunday, you know. Sunday, I don't know if we're going to be on Super Bowl Sunday. We may be off that night, man. I just may give you all an OG Sunday break. You know, I'll let you watch the Super Bowl, let everybody enjoy themselves, Queen and everybody. You know what I mean? We'll probably be off on Sunday, let everybody enjoy the Super Bowl and all that. We'll be back, you know, following Sunday back, doing it how we do it. You dig, Queen Jean? Is that okay?
I can dig it. Yeah, I can dig it. I'm going to be sitting up here like one man by myself watching this. Like, I'm excited about it, too. I'm ready to see them 49ers
win
the championship.
The 49ers?
49ers,
okay,
yeah.
The Niners, then. Everybody rolling with the Niners. Shout out to the Niners.
I'm going with the Niners.
Should be a good game, though. I'm just looking forward to it, you know, so. So love, man. Anything else, Queen G? You got to hit him with till we talk to him again.
Nothing else. Just everybody have a blessed night. Until we see you on Friday. Love on your loved ones. Hug your loved ones. You know, tell your loved ones you love them. And that's about it. You know, peace and blessings to everybody.
Mm. Yes. That part right there is the G Lou Show. I don't know. Like what? What'd you say, Queen?
I said, that's my EOW to everybody, my end of watch. That's what EOW stands for. End of watch. And then KUE means, KUE. What time is it? KUE 0024. That means we out. Those are just my dispatching days.
We outie. Okay.
Yeah, you need to get you some rest. Yeah,
right,
true.
I ain't had none. 3 days.
No, you haven't had none in almost a week or two.
Man, for real.
No real
rest, because you're doing
Boss King things. You're making sure everything is straight with the show, the podcast, you know, so... You know, you got to rest of tonight, tomorrow. Just get you some rest.
Yeah.
Create some memories, you know. Create some good memories.
Right.
Where you
That's
are.
Thank you, now. Queen. I'm going to take that advice.
Yeah.
You know, and thank you, everybody, for the prayers, too, man. You know, they're working. You know what I mean? So thank you, everybody, for the prayers. Everybody praying for me and the fam. Much appreciated. I love y'all, man. On my mama, the G Lou Show, West Side Wednesdays, Flashback Fridays, OG Sundays, Queen Jean G Lou, OG Hank, Flossie B, all my loved ones, Dee Dee Harrison, Mama Boo Boo, what's up, baby? Shout out to James, Big D, Rev Ali, Dude Snow at the Round Table, man. This is what we do every Wednesday night. We love y'all for that. We're going to be out of here tonight.
Yeah.
Keep it real.
Down for the same team, what it seems to be reality is just a dream. Out of eye, the colors that I wear is do or die. When I walk down the street, well, I meet evil in disguise. So, I told a fofo with hollow tips. But my mind telling me, should I not? Or should I pull it? What I represent, God only knows what lies for myself. Jealousy and hatred, niggas is out for my wealth. While I perish, let it selfish for the rest of my life. Cause those who live wrong is bound to live a short life. Will money be the root of my destruction? Without the money, I can't even seem to function.
Now there's nowhere for me to turn, there's nowhere for me to hide from reality.
As complex as the situation gets, I remain, I maintain. Ain't that much strain to make me twist myself like Kurt Cobain. Oh shit, I don't believe it. Some niggas that I fuck with trying to pull a twist, but ain't that much twisted in existence. And this is how you show me love. It shows me exactly what money's capable of.
That's right.
Now is it the expenses that make you want to catch me slipping and pay your visit? Cause this is for all my homies. For Jack is only from Twist to the fools in L.A. that know me. I'm back with the fifth of him, corrupting the nigga dads on the mash again.
Now there's nowhere for me.
Got no time for no gangs in the world of madness. Will my composure be the same? Will my friends be around when they rest me in the ground? A lost soul, lost forever, never ever to be found. Life ain't what it seems. For the niggas full of schemes, on the hunt full of cash, the one that blast with the grief. These sick bitches wanna get a nigga caught up for what? A simple nut, a simple fuck.
Daily it enhances the penitentiary chances to survive in 1995. So I got 1995 ways to survive nowadays. Time and time again, I bust a rhyme again, cause I'ma get in deeper shit if I can break the crime again. How to mentally convert me, the same niggas out to hurt me, it irks me, strenuous controversy. What's next on the list to complete after all this shit that popped off on the streets and all eyes on me? But I won't change sides, cause what I represent till I die. It's time for me to grab a tall glass of you see, my ways is the phase on them niggas that try me. Leave them laying stiff if they ain't no IVs. IVs, they're hoarders, regardless, fool. Living life day and night, staying hoarded, crew. Keep my cool until my mood abruptly switch. Then I'm on a nigga's ass like Bumpy Zips.
That's right.
It's no remorse when you cross my course. I'm not a hunter, but take a nigga out for sports. Don't resort to thinking you could get with this, or you will be a eulogy if you insist to dismiss. The Trey D from L-O-N-G, V-E-A-C-H, where the hardest gangsters be. 21st was the worstest turf on the earth, yet I feel I was meant to represent from birth. Till I die, you wonder why it ain't no secret. Motherfuckers best be in love with this shit. Shit.
Run up on him and shoot his ass, you know. I ain't never shot in no house in my life.
something I refuse to do because the people in the house ain't got nothing to do with if me and you got a beef. If me and you got a beef, I was going to try to catch your ass and get you. If I see you at a store, you with your mama, you with your girl, you with your kid, I wouldn't even do nothing. I'd just look at you and shake my head and you would know, motherfucker, I'm giving you a pass because you with your people and they ain't got nothing to do with it. We had rules to this shit.